Usually, streets like this in Melbourne's north are pumping from dawn to well after dusk.
From the early morning, you see people out for coffee, people taking their walk up and down.
Ben runs the local gym, and many of those early birds were his clients.
We open at 6 o'clock, and we've got people waiting outside before we actually open.
But all of that changed overnight when Victoria's COVID-19 shutdown hit in March.
It was very surreal because we didn't expect it to hit that fast. And for us, we found out the day before that we had to close by 12 p.m. the next day. And members were crying, actually, on their way out.
Gyms like Ben's may have to stay closed until September. That's except for the NT, where gyms will be open again from May 15. So for now, he's doing his best to innovate to keep his customers and his business fit.
Online or virtual training is definitely what's the next option. And we started to look into that immediately.
You managed to look through your program?
Yeah, it all looks fine.
Great.
Ben's not the only one struggling. Ligon Street is all but deserted, just like shopping strips across the country. More than two-thirds of Aussie businesses say the COVID-19 shutdowns have been a huge blow. And new modelling shows a potential $400 billion hit to Australia's bottom line over 6 months. Matt Hoffman runs the local craft brewery right next door to Ben's gym.
It's been a huge change. We're down to a skeleton crew. Trade has gone right down.
Normally, Temple Brewing is a hive of activity. The front of house team serving up cold beer and hot food, while the brewing team crafts out the back and packages up stock for delivery.
We plan to keep going as long as we can, but it's just been a massive hit.
Now the bar is closed, and Matt's team has set up a makeshift shop at the back to keep some sales ticking over.
It's working so far as keeping the doors open, but as far as how sustainable it can be, I mean, it's hard to tell. So we just kind of have to play it week by week at the moment.
One of the destinations for Temple's Brews is The Beast. Jared heads up the local music venue and burger joint.
We've seen an almost 70% drop in trade, and the business model has almost completely changed from like a hustle-bustle pub and dining hall and live music venue to a takeaway venue.
Paying customers buy their burgers through the front window or on delivery apps. Jared's also trying to help out some local casuals who've lost their shifts.
We've got a big community of musicians and artists and entertainers and hospitality workers and everybody else who's doing it pretty hard at the moment. So a couple of days a week, we're trying to cook up a bit of a meal so they can at least come and get a feed on us.
So far, they're keeping the lights on, but many businesses are hoping the shutdown doesn't go on for too long.
The closure of fitness will see a lot of fitness centres shut. Small fitness businesses like my own are not overly profitable. People have opened it, the owners are there because they're passionate. It is their life.
Like everyone, businesses here are keen for a return to normality.
This is a space that they come to away from work, away from their cares. So not having this relationship anymore with this space is something that I think will impact them on a big mental level moving forward.
The NT is set to reopen pubs and restaurants in 2 weeks, but Victoria is waiting until at least May 11 to announce any changes. So right now on Ligon Street, it's still just one step at a time.
Every day seems like a new set of challenges that we have to deal with. Hopefully when that does happen, we'll have a venue full of people partying and eating and dancing again, but until then, we'll just keep on plugging away day by day and trying to get through.
We've all got businesses that we see adapting nearest, no doubt, and that's great, but we can't underestimate just how significant a hit this is to them. I just hope that out the other side of this, that the lateral thinking that's required during this lockdown period then has a positive effect on society thereafter.
But it's so impressive how quickly they've pivoted, how quickly they've adapted.
Yeah.
And so many of these places, like my local cafes and restaurants that have changed with all of this that's gone on, their attitude is incredible. Like, it's such a relief to go and see these people. What I hope on the other side is that there is an awareness of accessibility so that we know that the people that can't get out day to day that we've kind of maybe neglected in the past, we now get an idea of what they've been going through and we can continue to help them.